It's been arranged and organised by them with a minimum input from me, other than mowing the lawn and making a speech. Oh yes, and that's right, and the berry fruit salad, yes. Now, this ceremony is a public display of the commitment Melinda and Matt have made to each other, a commitment they made many years ago and have accomplished. Therefore, I can't now welcome Matt into the family, since you have been welcomed and accepted long ago. Eileen was pretty pleased with your choice, Melinda. I don't see that today will bring about a major change in your lives, except perhaps from an end to the questions from uncles and aunts as to when you are going to get married. This is the opportunity for me to tell little stories about Melinda and about Matt. Fortunately for Melinda, my memory is not good enough to remember funny or remarkable or devastating incidents. Although I do remember you asking me not to pick you up in the larder, even though that was by far the most reliable car I ever owned, more reliable than the Peugeot or the Rover. The stories I've heard about Matt won't bear repeating. Oh, sorry, that was about someone else. Matt, it is probably as well that you didn't know our family better before meeting Melinda. Had you been aware of the strong managerial streak that runs through the brown woman, you may well have had different thoughts. You can already see it in Matilda's managing of her best friends. I do observe that you follow a successful strategy of letting Melinda make the small decisions, like where to live or how many children to have, and you make the major decisions, such as how many guitars to own. For a little over the last 2 years, I've lived with or near Melinda and Matt. That is almost all of Peter's life and about half of Matilda's. This is pretty congenial and undemanding for me. I potter around with whatever I'm able to do, make fluffies and honey on toast for Matilda and Peter. I allow them to watch much more Peppa Pig and Dora the Explorer and Diggers than their parents would like them to watch. As far as I can see, the two of you get on well together. I'm impressed with how well you manage the children, both of whom are delightful in a grandparent's eyes, if for no one else's. You've settled into the Curry House property and have made it your own, not Eileen's and mine. Curry House has become a house for children. Just look at all the toys there are in the hall there. You've breathed new life into the orchard and have employed a gardener who has no qualms about hacking the years of neglect out back under control. I am pleased to see this happen. I have great confidence in your future and I wish all of you the very best.